Well, this is September 21st at approximately 2:30 in the afternoon. Just been let back in, and that is what's left of the World Trade Center. About 8:25 p.m. on September 21st, Susan and I have just moved home, and this is what we see from our window. Things are really creepy down here. Pretty much welcome to Beirut. Bush gave a really strong speech the other night. A lot of people keep talking about how wonderful it was and how he's grown as a president. I just keep thinking that this is not going to be the last sight we see like this in America. And I keep this as long as it seems appropriate and run tape through it and talk to the camera. But right now, I just want to settle down and kind of get used to being home again. Hi, it's still September 21st. This is the view out of our other window. They've dredged out part of the Pier 25 area in order to make it deeper so they could bring in these heavy garbage barges. They've mounted a crane, and the crane is lifting material off the back of flatbeds that pull in periodically. You'd also see a large line of dump trucks that they're dropping material into, and the buses that the relief workers come in and out on. Down below is where we enter our apartment from. We have to cross up at Harrison, which is right there. That's our crossing point. We come across Harrison, walk along the highway, come to right about here, where these people are, and we're able to come up and along this path. We said earlier, I now feel like I am living in Beirut, or some other country that's in the middle of a war. It looks like we're going to be this way for a long, long time. The barges down below, as I said, are being filled with debris from the site. As they take that debris away off the back of the trucks, I wonder whether it's been sorted for bodies or not. At this point, they haven't found an intact body in days, so it's most likely they're just pulling it out, dumping it in, and they'll sort the parts after they take it to fresh kills or wherever it's going. Rather amazing, the entire site. But this is now where we live. Anyway, I don't know if that's it for tonight or not, but it's definitely not what I expected to be living in. Anyway, good night. Well, it's morning, about 10 a.m., September 23rd, and this is what the site looks like today. More and more cranes going up. It's been a couple days, I think, since I've dropped the shot. It's beautiful outside, at least as far as the weather's concerned. Last night, Susan and I came home, they kept changing our street crossings as we were lumbering around with 80, 90 pounds of junk between us. A couple of beers from going bar to lug our stuff down from the canal. But we got in all right, got settled. Susan's doing well. Last of the laundry now.
Still September 23rd. It's still morning, just a few minutes later. This is the crane outside of our house picking up. See, they're dredging out to make this deeper. That, I believe, is currently the tallest building in New York. You know, we see almost the base of the Empire State Building. Here in southern Beirut, they're clearly more and more cramped with the large pieces of heavy equipment. They've brought even more big Tonka toys into our neighborhood. Today is the 24th of September, and as you can see, we've got quite a production line set up, clearing away debris and loading it onto barges. Take a look now at the site where they are still excavating. That's not the site of excavation. That's Frodo. Frodo!
Aww. Aww.
That's the excavation October 1st, 8:38 a.m.